Hello, this is Matthias. Do you know how to build a running total? Multiple running totals at the same time? Well, I have videos on List.Generate for running totals, and I got the question if it's possible to adapt these solutions to cover multiple columns at the same time. So for example, we have here a column for sales, a column for cost of goods sold, and a column for allowance. And next to it, you see here three running totals. So how to do this? So I have already changed this to a table with Control plus T, and can go right to the data tab and with from table range, import it to the Power Query editor. There we have our data, and we will start off with building a custom function, new query, other sources, and all the way down to blank query. And then in the advanced editor, first thing we do is we bring in the parameters. Start off with only one values. List. And this is only for demonstration. Of course, you can build all three parameters at the same time. For learning purpose, let's start with one only. So call this running total. And call this here running total as well, so I don't forget it. Now let's go here for list generate. And list generate has three mandatory functions or parameters. First one is initial. That function defines the starting values. Then there is condition, which defines how often are we repeating the process. And next is the function which is defining the values for each step. So let's start off with brackets, equal sign. The equal sign comes after the bracket, and then the bigger sign. And then we will define running total. Starting value. So one more time, the starting value is values, first value of that list. How do we get the first value of values? By writing a zero in curly brackets, because lists are zero based. That's the first value of values. Then we have a counter. We need a counter, and we call this counter I like integer. We will start off with a zero. So these are our starting values. And condition, how often are we going to continue with this? Well, as long as the previous counter value is smaller than list count. Of values. That's our list. Yes. So now we have to define the function which is giving us in each step new values for the running total and the counter. So let's start off with the running total. And that's the previous value of running total. Plus values, and at which position? So that's the previous counter value. So square brackets, the I, that's one. And we have to count up the counter as well. So I equals previous value of the counter. That's one. So we are basically done, but we can add one optional parameter. This is the selector. We do have the running total plus the count. And we're only interested in the running total, so let's bring this here. Running total. And if everything goes well, I can rename this to fx, select function, running total. Fx makes it easy to call that function. And let's go here to the data and call it in a custom step. And that custom step is table from columns. Table from columns has two lists. One is for the columns and the other one is for column names. Let's enlarge the formula bar and look after the columns first. So we will go for table two columns from the previous step, source, and that will give us all the columns from the previous step. We will add to this another column. And we get this from calling that function, fx running total. And we'll add here one list buffer, because if you have more than just these example rows, let's say you have 200,000 or more rows, you need this to speed up things. So what we need here is the previous step, of course, and that column is called sales. Good. Let's add a comma here and then go for the column names, table column names of the previous step, just source, and we will add one more, and that's where we can go for running total abbreviated. See how that works out. Well, that works out fine for the sales, and we now can add another column exactly the way, same way, and another one for allowance, again the same way. But it's better to adapt the custom column for three columns. Let's come here to the advanced editor one more time and add two more parameters. First one is cost of goods sold, and this is list as well. And a third one was allowance. List. So we've got three parameters, and we need to get also three starting values. Let me just copy this twice and change the name. So not running total anymore, but sales running total, because we have multiple running totals. It's cost of goods sold running total, and a third one is allowance running total. Good, we have to do the same game here as well. We have three running totals, so let's copy this twice and change the name. And here it's more work because it's two or three times to type this. And it's very easy to make mistakes. So this one is not changed, and this one is cost of goods sold running total. I have to spend this here as well. Cost of goods sold running total. This one has to be changed to CBooks. Yes. So only the last one has to go out as well. allowance. And allowance. Quite often I've got the chance to write this wrong. Okay, so it's better to use IntelliSense. Now, I want more than just the running total, which, by the way, doesn't exist anymore. I want them all. So let's take the selector out. And we will do the selection in the query itself and not in this function. So let's come here. There's an error. Why is an error here? Because we have only one parameter defined. And so we have to do this copying game one more time. So first one is for the cost of goods sold. And the second time is for allowance. Okay, let's keep the fingers crossed. Our records, that's good. Let's see, yes, they look very good. We have all three running totals plus the counter. Now let's just quickly select all the running totals, and there's no need for a prefix. Well, that's exactly what we wanted to have. We have now three columns with running totals. And we did it in two steps. First, we built the standard custom function for only one column, and then expanded it for three columns. And of course, you can do it also differently, going directly for three columns in this custom function. This was just for illustration, having first the one column solution and then the three column solution. Hope you learned something. And if there was any value in that video, please press the like button, because that increases the chance that other people can see this video. And I hope you enjoyed it. Until the next time, bye.